animation has lots of uses that we can use it for. And it is super fun and I'm just enjoying it. But before we get to the stage of creating very cool animation like Pikachu, let's do the basics like boiling text, how to create a flag, as well as bouncing ball. Join me and let's do this. I have tested a few free 2D animation apps and I've settled on FlipaClip. This software is free and you can download it from your Android store or your Apple store. And the only snag with it is that you're going to be getting ads while you're busy designing and you're going in and out. But the yearly fee is also not that expensive. However, if you want to try it out for free, you can download it. And for this tutorial, we're going to be using FlipaClip. I also tested Canva. It's a little bit of a nightmarish. At the end of this video, you must let me know if you want me to upload the Canva video that I've done. But let's jump right in.
We're going to open FlipaClip. We're going to click on the plus button and we're going to name our animation. So this is going to be a boiling text. So we're going to call it BT and we're going to select a canvas at the bottom of the page. You can select the size and then you can also select the frames per second. We're going to leave it at 12 frames per second, which means every second there's a frame that is being played by FlipaClip. We're going to click on create a project and then it's opening up our canvas. Then we're going to pick a pen, and when you select a pen or a brush or a crayon, you can choose the thickness of the pen. So we can make this nice pen of ours maybe 15 or 16, and then we can change the color and make it a nice bright orangey color. And then we're going to go back and we are on our canvas. This is where we're going to write the name to make the text boil. The less you draw each frame identically, the more it boils. So I'm going to start writing my own name. That's frame one, and I'm going to create second frame. The nice thing about FlipaClip, on the second frame, it shows you the previous frame so that you can write the name again. So the less you write identically, the more it boils. Not going to do a lot of these. Nice thing about FlipaClip, it loops and your text is boiling as easy as that. The next basic animation we're going to do together is bouncing ball. You have not learned animation if you have not created a bouncing ball. We're going to create a straight line at the bottom of the page and then we're going to be bouncing our ball. So it all starts with a ball at the top of the first frame and then you click on the plus button to create the second ball. So the further apart your ball is, the more it will bounce. Almost at the end of the bounce, you will create the squishy ball. Okay, that looks weird. There we go. And then you're going to start creating the ball bouncing up. And let's have a look. There's our ball. So we need to make sure that each frame has a line to show that this is our ground. I really would not like to have that line bounce like that. I want it to be consistent, but you get the gist of how a bouncing ball works. You need to be creating each frame like a clip to show that the ball is bouncing up and down.
Last easy one we're going to create together is a flag.
And to make things a little bit interesting, we're going to change our background. We're going to click on the save and access the backgrounds that are available, as well as paper and other functionalities or as backgrounds that are available. So you can pick a background or you could pick a paper background and then go back and then it would add it to your canvases that you're going to be working on. We're going to leave the 12 frames per second as well as the canvas size and then click on create a project.
What I've seen and what I'm learning with animation is that
The first frame is the foundation. The next frames that come after that needs to be slightly different in order for the animation to start effect. So this is scene number one, or our frame number one, and we're going to be creating the pole. And the pole is going to be throughout our whole animation. And then the flag is going to be different slightly on each frame. Okay, I'm happy with a pen, and I'm going to leave it as black. And then I want to start adding my pole. Then we click to add frame number two. To have your flag wave with the wind, you need to make it slightly different on your second frame. Not a lot, just slightly different. I think you get the gist of how to create a flag. So slight movement, a lot of frames makes your flag pick up the wind and go with the flow. Animation is quite fun, right?
On our next video, we're creating how to create a walk using 2D animation. For now, you can go watch how to add a mouth or a talking on your animation using Canva. Thank you for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.